Following the release of a 2024 primary leaving exam results, secondary schools across the country have today started their selection exercise. Dr. Jane Egau, the Undersecretary of the Ministry of Education and Sports, highlighted expectations for this year's selection.
At this year's placement exercise, we are expecting a total of 4,293 secondary schools to participate. This number of 4,000 includes 1,325 government and government-aided secondary schools implementing USE, and we also have 112 government-aided secondary schools that are implementing non-USE, and then we have 2,856 private secondary schools. In total, we have 648,662 students that we are supposed to place at this exercise.
It is reported that some of the top performing schools have already raised their cut-off points due to the steep competition by learners. Egau assured parents of fairness and transparency in the selection exercise and urged her teachers not to delay parents seeking admission.
I want to say, please let's be fair to the candidates and also to their parents. Please do not leave someone with a 4 and take another one with a 20 in the schools, because they tell us, okay, you say this school stopped at 5, but there are people there with a 20, there are people there with a 13, there are people there with even more than 20. It is unfair, and the public judges us wrongly on that matter. It's better, and then also please listen to the parents.
Some of the head teachers who participated in the selection exercise had this to say.
People have interest in coming to the school. You understand its excellencies. Study has been there, and people want to be admitted there. The structure is affordable to the parents.
Director of Studies at St. Peter's SS in Zambia. This year, we had applicants up to around 1,055. According to the cutoffs that we've selected and 8, we are taking up to 8, up to 400 students, both boys and girls. So our cutoff is 8.
Meanwhile, the director of basic and secondary education, Dr. Ismail Mulindwa, representing the permanent secretary, stressed that there is need for government to allocate more funds for the recruitment of more teachers to cater for the increasing number of students.
As head teachers, you play a central role in the delivery of quality education through planning, implementing and supervising teaching and learning related activities in schools. And we can achieve this by building effective teams from our staff, both teaching and non-teaching, and by effective supervision of the teaching and learning processes. Ladies and gentlemen, studies have indicated that the morale and motivation of most of our teachers in our schools is quite low. More so, there's teacher absenteeism and limited time to task.
He appealed to the head teachers to register with the Education Management Information System for grants and discouraged quick removal of teachers from payroll after transfers.
He has to be given a loan. He has to continue working until when he finally gets a letter transferring him to another station. Many of you or many of us are quick to remove these teachers from the payroll. You might have had issues with this teacher, but please, you have to retain the teacher until when he's officially transferred.
The two-day selection event concludes tomorrow and senior one term begins on February 19th. Story by Sharon Navasirie for the news.